Dear students, before we proceed with this experiment, I would like you to see the video that has been uploaded for a prism which shows the refraction of light through glass prism. Today we will be doing a similar experiment. Aim to determine angle of minimum deviation by plotting a graph between angle of incidence and angle of deviation. The apparatus required: you need a drawing board, prism, protractor, drawing pins, bell pins, a pencil, half meter scale, a white sheet of paper and a graph paper. Theory: when a light ray enters the prism, it bends towards the base of the prism. The angle at which light ray bends in prism is called angle of deviation, and it is represented as D or delta. The value of D depends on I of prism with large angle. The value of D is large for small value of I. When I increases, D decreases initially to dm. This is called the angle of minimum deviation. After that value of D, it increases. So R is equal to A by 2, or I is equal to A plus dm by 2. This is the diagram for refraction through prism at different angles. Place a white sheet on the drawing board. Secure the white sheet with bell pins. With the help of a meter scale, draw a line. Mark this line as X, Y. Choose suitable points . Mark these points as O. Take a protractor, place the protractor at point O, mark 90 degree, join the lines. This will act as a normal, so let the normal be NO. Keep the protractor again at point O, such that the baseline of the protractor will coincide along the normal. Choose an angle of 30 degree and mark here angle I is equal to 30 degree. Let this ray be named as PO. So PO is the incident ray. Place two pins exactly vertical at an approximate distance of 5 cm. Now place the prism in this way such that the normal comes exactly midway of the base of the prism. After gently placing it, trace the outline of the prism. And name it as A, B, and C. Name this as P1 and P2. So the pins are named as pin P1 and pin P2. Now you have to look at this incident ray from this face of the prism. That means in the direction of the pencil, you have to look at this incident ray of PO along this face of AC to get the refracted light. Try to locate the two pins P1 and P2 from the face AC by slowly adjusting the position of your head. So now you can see the two pins along the face AC of the prism, and adjust the position of your head in such a way that the two pins P1 and P2 fall exactly in a straight line. Now place the third pin in such a way that the pin P3 is kept on the white sheet of paper such that now the pin P1, P2 and P3 all fall in a single straight line. After fixing the pin P3, now you have to fix a pin P4 in such a way now that the pin P1, P2, P3 and P4 all falls in a straight line. So you can see that now all the pins comes in a straight line. So we can name this pin as P3 and this pin as P4. Remove the pins and encircle the pin pricked areas. Remove the prism. Again encircle the pin pricked areas. Join the P3 and P4 pins. This line will give us the emergent ray. Slightly extrapolate it into the prism. Similarly, you can extrapolate the incident ray . Now this incident ray is PT. This angle can be called as delta or D, which represents angle of deviation. Keep the protractor at this point and measure the angle. So you can see here now we have got an angle of 46 degrees. That means the D is equal to 46 degrees. Similarly, repeat the procedure for various angles like 35 degrees, 40, 45 degrees, 50 degrees, 55 degrees and 60 degrees. So the angle chosen for this experiment must be between 30 degrees and 60 degrees. The first diagram shows for an angle of incidence of 30 degree, the angle of deviation is 46 degree. For second figure, the angle of incidence is 35 degree, the angle of deviation is 44 degree. For the third figure, the angle of incidence is 40 degree, the angle of deviation is 42 degree. For the fourth figure, the angle of incidence is 45 degree, the angle of deviation is 40 degree. For the fifth, the angle of incidence is 50 degree, the angle of deviation is 39 degree. For the sixth figure, the angle of incidence is 55 degree, the angle of deviation is 40 degree. For the seventh figure, the angle of incidence is equal to 60 degree, the angle of deviation is 41 degree. After finding the angle of deviation for the corresponding angle of incidence, input the values in the tabular column as shown. Model graph. Choose angle of incidence along x-axis and angle of deviation along y-axis. Plot the graph by drawing a freehand curve. Draw a tangent on the lowest point of curve and parallel to x-axis. The lowest point of curve gives the minimum angle of deviation. So here you can see the angle of deviation delta or dm is equal to 39 degree. Result, angle of minimum deviation dm is equal to 39 degree.